Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to my channel and let's do freshest PSVR news in the village. And in this video, I'm gonna talk about Blade and Sorcery PSVR version. This is one of those games that I've been asked a lot about. Blade and Sorcery, Hellsprit Arena, Undead Citadel and Gorn. Those games seems to be very, very popular with PSVR owners because I kept being asked about them, especially Gorn. Now listen. There is nothing new about Gorn that I know, so don't bother asking. Once I know anything, I will pass it on straight away with a speed of light to keep you up to date. But also with the Undead Citadel, it got delayed to Q2 2020. With Hellsprit Arena, I don't know much. Regarding the Blade and Sorcery PSVR version, couple of months ago I published a video when the developer said they not planning on doing PSVR port at the moment, and it was sad times, because why? This game looks amazing, tons of videos on YouTube, people enjoying it, looks awesome. But as we know, of course, plans might change. And it looks like the plans have changed, because the developers posted brand new roadmap for the game on their Steam page, and basically they said what updates they gonna do, shit ton of work they gonna put to this game. It's gonna be awesome when it's fully released, but also they said once the game reaches 1.0, which is the full release on Steam, then they gonna look into the PSVR port, if technically possible. That's exactly what they said. Now, this meaning that they are looking into PSVR port now, but is it technically possible? What does that mean? Well, basically, indie studios, you know, they're not big, there's not many of the developers in them, and also, let's don't forget, they need to make sure that the game gonna run on PS4 original, which is not as powerful and optimizing for PSVR. From what I know, it's quite difficult, but also there is a little hope, because listen, this is for quest owners. They said after 1.0 release, they're gonna look into quest release as well, if technically possible. And I'm always thinking, if they can run game on quest, then they can easily run it on PSVR, because of course quest is not as powerful as even PS4, more like I would say Xbox 360 or PS3, maybe not even, I don't know, but anyway. So basically what it means, they looking to bring this game to other platforms, and of course for us PSVR owners this is a very good news, because people are definitely liking this game, they are very excited about it, and of course they keep asking developers what's happening with it. So finally I think after all the demands, all the comments, everything what people been just probably doing their head in with, they said fuck it, we're gonna do it, we're gonna try to bring it to PSVR. So I'm assuming once they fully release the game, they're gonna get themselves PSVR development kit and they're gonna start working on PSVR version and see if they can run it. Now, when the 1.0 release gonna come, I have no idea, might be even next year, I don't know. But if it is next year, then it's probably gonna be on PS5. And if PS5 gonna be the platform they gonna release on, then of course the optimizing shouldn't be as bad, because how much powerful PSVR gonna be on PS5. But anyway, that's your info about Blade and Sorcery. Hope you're satisfied. Let me know in comment section what you think about this information. Are you looking forward to Blade and Sorcery? And of course, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.